Cars are an integral part of just about everyone's life. For most people, owning a car will be a necessity that can't be avoided. But there are multiple things to consider before taking that step. These include things such as choosing the right brand and model, and how you decide how to pay for the vehicle, either by buying it or leasing it. In this video, I'll talk about the two options and help you decide which one is right for you. Let's go. Hey, this is Carlos with Influential Finance, and on this channel, I make weekly videos to help you improve your personal finances. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. Let's start off with talking about buying a car. Buying a car is currently the most popular option. Buyers can either pay in cash or take out a loan through their bank and pay in installments over time. Whichever the choice, the buyer ends up owning the vehicle and has more flexibility in its management. The biggest advantage of buying a car is acquiring equity, which can be later used as trade-in value to purchase your next vehicle. However, cars are depreciating assets, and even a brand new car can lose as much as 9 to 11% of its value from the moment it is driven off the lot. One way you can get around this is by choosing a brand and model that can hold its value very well. Another disadvantage of buying a car is that once the warranty period expires, you'll be solely responsible for all of the maintenance and repair work. This can be pricey depending on the make and model of the car, as well as how well it has been maintained. Now, let's talk about leasing a car. Leasing a car is essentially a long-term version of a car rental. A lease agreement usually spans over a 3 to 4 year period where the person leasing pays a periodic payment to a car dealership in exchange for borrowing the vehicle. The biggest appeal of leasing is its affordability. Leasing costs are lower upfront, but only really make financial sense if the lease period doesn't extend beyond 3 to 4 years. According to Experian's State of the Automotive Finance Market report, which I will leave linked in the description of this video, car loans are on average $108 more expensive than lease payments. However, over time, leases will get more expensive and can end up significantly exceeding the cost of buying a car. Another drawback of lease agreements is that there are strict limitations on how you can use the vehicle. This includes mileage limits as well as vehicle maintenance requirements. Furthermore, leasing agreements can be quite complicated, and unless you do your research, you can end up paying way more than expected. So, what are the differences between the two? When it comes to buying a vehicle, consumers tend to work with the bank to secure a car loan and then purchase the vehicle. Many banks have specific requirements with the level of insurance required on the car, and some even require you to get gap insurance. Gap insurance is basically insurance coverage that helps you pay off your auto loan if your car is totaled or stolen and you owe more than your car is worth. The primary issue with a car loan is that due to the steep depreciation of vehicles, many borrowers can end up upside down, which just means that they owe more than what the car is worth. So if you plan on selling or trading in your car before it is paid off, you may have additional costs beyond the value of your car. Leasing, on the other hand, doesn't require a car loan. This means that you are only obligated to pay up to the contract date, and then you can hand over the keys. This makes it an excellent option for those that prefer to have a new car every few years. However, if you have a long commute or you just tend to drive more than the average person, leasing is not a good option for you, since you will likely exceed the dealership's mileage limits. And lastly, leased vehicles can also be purchased at the end of the contract. So, what is a better use of your money? Buying a car is typically a much better investment than leasing it. And just to be clear, I'm using the word investment very lightly here because it's not like a car is an investment. It's not like your car's value is going to go up. While buying a car involves more upfront money, there is more long-term value to be gained from owning a vehicle since you'll be able to drive it longer and use the remaining equity when you trade in your car. Whether you choose to eventually sell or trade in the car, having bought the car will make your next purchase more affordable, unlike leasing. Car leases can be a good option for some people that are willing to pay up to always have a brand new car and are able to stay within the dealership's limits. However, this cost would eventually exceed that of buying the same vehicle. So if you're going to lease your car, make sure that you are okay with this financial decision, knowing that you are going with the most expensive option long term. Regardless of which option you choose, you should first first make it a point to understand your needs and do some research before making your choice. That pretty much wraps it up for this video, but if you'd like to continue watching videos on my channel, I'll leave two more videos linked right over here. As always, make sure you click on my face right here to subscribe for more weekly videos. That's been it. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.